Mark Sweeney, the Sweeney Dog. Sweeney, we want you to give us your top five candidates for the AL MVP as it stands today.
Man, there's some great performances in the American League. Almost 40 games left in the season, so there's time to make an impact on the pressure points. So the first choice in number five is going to be interesting. I'm going to go up to the Bay Area for Matt Chapman. And why I'm going to Matt Chapman? First and foremost, he is an elite defender. Think about Nolan Arenado. I think Matt Chapman favors very well defensively with him. Also, improved numbers offensively, exit velocity off the bat. He has the ability to impact the game defensively, but he is a very good base runner. I think the Oakland A's have a building block, and Matt Chapman needs to have some credibility here because not a lot of people will get to watch him play. The Oakland A's are relevant because of Matt Chapman.
He's their Nolan Arenado. He brings a defense, he brings a swagger, and you see him out of that group of youngsters, he's starting to emerge as their leader.
You go with him over Chris Davis?
Chris Davis is putting up those numbers. I think it's the total package that you have to look at Matt Chapman and why he just favors a little bit over Chris
Davis. Elite defender, good runner, that type of thing. Okay, fair enough. Let's go to number four on your list.
Well, interesting that the Boston Red Sox are the best team in baseball the regular season, and they're putting up numbers. Free agent signing, I'm going to go J.D. Martinez. Might surprise a lot of people why he's fourth, because I think the DH has a lot of relevance in this scenario. Now, that being said, J.D. Martinez is set up possibly to be a Triple Crown winner, much like Miguel Cabrera did in 2012. If he does that, he goes right at the top of the list, because if you can do that offensively in Boston, you deserve this award.
I've known this kid since high school. I gave up his first career home run, signed his baseball. He's developed and worked with Miguel Cabrera, and now you're seeing the Miguel Cabrera swagger at the plate. Really proud of this kid.
Oh, he's number four?
Yeah, that's hard.
I mean,
that's
the best hitter in the
Sweeney
game
dog.
Right now.
Are you from Boston, Sweeney Dog?
All right, you got to impress us now. Let's go, Sweeney. Who you got for number three?
Well, I'm always trying to impress you guys. But number three, it's the career year of Jose Ramirez in Cleveland. What an unbelievable performance in the month of July alone. Ended up hitting 18 extra base hits, 25 RBI. He continues to get those extra base hits in their clutch. He is doing it on both sides of the baseball, and defensively, he has improved at third base. I think Jose Ramirez is having that career year at the perfect time because Lindor and Ramirez, that's a great combination to have.
Yeah, quality at bats, quiet at the plate, knows his strike zone, doesn't miss the barrel on both sides of the plate. And I do agree with Sweeney Dog. He can play second base and third base. He's very valuable in that lineup.
All right, number two, you're going just south of where we currently are situated in our studio right now, or what? What do you got?
I think everyone starts talking about this guy, and it's Mike Trout. Everyone expects that he is either going to win the award or come in second. That's what he did his first 5 years. Mike Trout has that wrist injury. It's a bad timing for him right now. But you look at Mike Trout's numbers, he's on base over 46% of the time. He continues to improve his game, and arguably he's the best player in the game of baseball. I think Mike Trout has to be close to the top of the list. If he comes back after this injury and he puts up the normal numbers, he could vaunt into that number one spot, even with the Angels struggling this year.
He's the best all-around athlete in baseball. Power, speed, swagger. You know, I got a chance to watch him 3 days. It was a shock when he didn't get on base. I mean, that's how talented he is. And, you know, quietly, this is the best player in baseball.
Who is number one on the Sweeney Dog list?
Well, when you talk about J.D. Martinez and the year he's had, well, it's unfortunate, but Mookie Betts on the same club has had an actual better year. He's hitting 350 coming into today. This guy can impact the game on all facets, right, and he really becomes the face for the Boston Red Sox. At the perfect time, he's having his career year. Remember, he came in second in 2016 in the MVP race. Down year last year offensively, J.D. Martinez is making Mookie Betts up his game another level. Mookie Betts, to me, is a defender. He can run the bases with the stolen bases. He can impact the game so much. And you know what? At the best times, he peaks. And that's why I say Mookie Betts is the MVP at this point of the season.
You agree?
Yeah, I do agree. Especially he relishes in the big moments, and he made everybody better in that locker room. He's always smiling. He's always bringing big energy, and he's motivating this team to be the best in baseball. You see him time after time with big highlights, coming up with big hits. But I just love his swagger. We got to come up with the ball spot, though. We got to work on that ball spot, though. But again, he's the best player in baseball right now.
That's why he wears a cap.
Baseball cap is on. You have to work on that. Sweeney Dog, nice job. The top five AL MVP candidates, according to Mark Sweeney.